Hi everyone, welcome to EngNerd Math. In this video, I will teach you about division of fractions. So in division of fractions, we will also apply the process in multiplication of fractions because when we divide fractions, we simply find first the reciprocal of the divisor and then multiply that divisor by the first fraction or the dividend. So therefore, we must know how to multiply fractions so that we can apply that knowledge when we are dividing fractions. So by the way, I already have a previous video about multiplication of fractions. So if you haven't watched that yet, I will just put the link of the video in the description so you can check it first. Okay? So if you try to write the rules for division of fractions, as applying what I've said, we have, let's say, the fraction A over B divided by the fraction C over D. It is simply equal to A over B times the reciprocal of the divisor, which is C over D. So getting the reciprocal, meaning we will interchange the denominator and the numerator, we have A over B times D over C. And then applying the rules for multiplication of fractions, we simply get the product of the numerators A and D. So we have A times D or AD over the product of the denominators B and C. So we have B times C or BC. So therefore, the answer is AD over BC. Okay? So for example, applying this rule, let's say we have 1/4 divided by 1/2. So we will simply multiply 1/4 by the reciprocal of 1/2, which is 2 over 1. And then we can apply the multiplication rule for fractions. So as what we did on the video of multiplication of fractions, we can also apply cancellation. That is, we can cancel out common factors in the numerator and denominator. So we can do that by factoring out the 4 in the denominator as 2 times 2, right? Then times 2 over 1. So we cannot factor out the numerator and denominator of 2 over 1, so we left it as that. And then we can cancel out now common factor in the numerator and denominator. So obviously, we can factor out this pair of 2. So we have, for the first fraction, we are left at 1 over 2 times for the second fraction, 1 over 1. So we can now multiply the numerator. We have 1 times 1 is 1 over. Multiply the denominator, 2 times 1 or 2. So therefore, the final answer is 1/2. Okay? Likewise, if we divide 2/3 by 5 over 6, so it is equivalent to multiplying 2/3 times the reciprocal of 5 over 6, which is 6 over 5. So the numerator and denominator of 2/3 cannot be factored anymore. So just copy 2/3 times. For 6 over 5, 6 can be factored as 3 times 2. Over 5 cannot be factored anymore, so that we can cancel out this pair of 3 in the numerator and denominator, and we are left for the first fraction 2 over 1, right, times for the second fraction 2 over 5. So we can now multiply the numerators. 2 times 2 is 4 over, multiply the denominators, 1 times 5 is 5. So therefore, the final answer is 4 over 5. Okay, next, what if we are dividing a fraction by a whole number, let's say 3? So if we encounter a whole number in division of fractions, we can transform the whole number first into a fraction by dividing it by 1. Just like in multiplication of fractions, right? So we can write it first as 3/4 divided by 3 over 1. So that we can apply now the rule for division of fractions. That is, copy the first fraction 3/4, then proceed to multiplication. But this time, get the reciprocal of the divisor, which is 3 over 1. So the reciprocal is 1/3. So we can now proceed to multiplying 3/4 times 1/3. So obviously, we can cancel out readily the 3 in the numerator and denominator. So we are left for the first fraction as 1 over 4 times for the second fraction 1 over 1. So multiplying the numerators, we have 1 times 1 is 1 over, multiplying the denominators, 4 times 1 is 4. So therefore, the final answer is 1/4. Okay? Likewise, if we are dividing 2 by 2/5. So again, we have a whole number 2. So we can transform it first into fraction by writing it as 2 over 1 and then divided by 2/5. So we now have 2 over 1 times the reciprocal of 2/5 is 5 over 2. And we can readily cancel out 2 in the numerator and denominator. So we are left at the first fraction as 1 over 1 times for the second fraction, 5 over 1. So multiplying the numerators, we have 1 times 5 is 5 over multiplying the denominators, 1 times 1 is 1. So that the final answer is 5 over 1 or simply 5. Next, what if this time we are dividing a mixed number by a fraction? So let's say we have 1 and 3 over 8 divided by 11 over 12. So just like in multiplication of fractions, when we encounter a mixed number, we will convert them first into improper fractions. So if we convert 1 and 3 eighths into improper fraction, we have 1 times 8 is 8 plus 3 is 11. So that 1 and 3 eighths is equivalent to 11 over 8. Then we have divided by 11 over 12. Now following the rule for division of fractions, we have 11 over 8 times reciprocal of 11 over 2 is 12 over 11. So we can factor out the numerators and denominators of the first fraction. For 11, already prime, so just copy. For 8, it can be factored as 2 times 4, then times. For 12 over 11, 12 can be factored as 4 times 3 over 11, the same, cannot be factored, just copy. And then we can apply cancellation. So obviously we can cancel out 11 in the numerator and denominator as well as the 4 in the numerator and denominator. So we are left for the first fraction as 1 over 2 times for the second fraction as 3 over 1, right? So multiplying now the numerators, we have 1 times 3 is 3 over the product of the denominators, 2 times 1 is 2. Therefore, the final answer is 3 halves, or we can convert it into mixed number by dividing 3 by 2. So 3 divided by 2 is 1, 1 times 2 is 2, subtract 3 minus 2 is 1. So the 3 halves is equivalent to 1 and 1 over 2. Okay? Next, what if we have 1 and 1 half divided by 1 and 1 third? So in this case, we have two mixed numbers. So we can convert them first into improper fractions. So for 1 and 1 half, we have 1 times 2 is 2 plus 1 is 3. So we have 3 over 2 divided by. For 3 and 1 third, we have 3 times 1 is 3 plus 1 is 4. So we have 4 over 3. And then applying the rules for division of fractions, we have 3 halves times the reciprocal of 4 thirds is 3 fourths. So as we can see, we don't have a common factor in the numerator and denominator anymore for the two fractions. So we can proceed to multiplying directly the numerators and denominators. So for the numerators, we have 3 times 3 is 9. Over for the denominators, we have 2 times 4 is 8. Therefore, the final answer is 9 over 8, or you can convert it into mixed number as 1 and 1 over 8. Okay? Okay, so I think that's it for this video, division of fractions. So I hope you learned something from this video, and thank you for watching.